Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and today we're going to play the brand new Steam game, Osiris New Dawn. It's yet another early access open world survival game. I know some people are like, there's so many of them, but this one looks especially cool. It's set in space. We love space, and really we've just gone back to our roots a little bit with some good old-fashioned survival stuff. I really like the look of this. We're going to go ahead and start off in single player until we kind of know what we're doing. We're just going to have a little play today, and okay, so we've got two factions, we've got all these classes, unavailable. This is early access, because when are they not early access? But really, I think we'd want to be a scientist anyway, wouldn't we? So we can be the United Nations of Earth, which is a globalized coalition of nations cooperating to make mankind a multiplanetary species. We can be the Outlanders, a band of space pirates. No. No. I'm a good man. Okay, let's do our suit up a little bit, primary color. Yeah, I think we can go orange. I think that's kind of cool. Why not detail that color? No, that's awful. Black. I'm looking kind of badass. I'm supposed to get the... Yeah, there we go. Name. His name, you ask, is Sir, because he's like a lord of space. Finley. Because he's British, obviously. Buckingham. Sir Finley Buckingham. What a man he is as well. Absolute hero from... Oh my god. Single player campaign. Planet. Proteus 2. Single player is perfect for practice and learning your character's tools, etc. That's kind of the idea. Aliens. We can set the number of aliens. Infested. All other things set to normal. Let's just get in there. Let's give it a go. Osiris New Dawn. I am really excited about this. We used to play a lot of survival games on the channel and we kind of toned it down a little bit. But it looks really interesting. I guess. I don't know. It's unique. There's not many space-based survival games where you're actually walking around and building up colonies and stuff like that. And the idea of taking this online, like, into multiplayer is actually kind of cool. Proteus 2, third moon of Theseus Prime, day one. Okay. It's very pretty. Okay. Open survival kit. Take all. This is immensely confusing. What is that over there? Okay, I'm gonna ignore that for now. I'm just gonna... I can't see a freaking thing. Kit used to build. Go to structures tab in your character menu. Select inflatable pickup. Okay, so we can make a dome. That's my personal assistant. That's a spooky little alien. I think the first thing we need to do is fix our bloody... we need to sort this out because... Go to the structures tab. Structures tab. There we go. Dome. Okay, I'm getting there. I'm running out of oxygen at a fairly alarming rate, though. Okay, I need to get inside my dome. I'm about to die, actually. I think I'm dead. In. Am I okay? Do I have air in the dome? I do have air in the dome. This is a bit vicious. I just started and... Oh, wait. Use patch tape to fix suit breach. Oh, I should have done that. There we go. Pretend that didn't happen. Press V to toggle camera perspective. Ah, there we go. Look at this! I'm gonna stick first person though. So, my mission at the moment is to find the ammo box. This is my lovely dome. I'm gonna call it Bill. No, I don't wanna be inside Bill. It's called Jennifer Lopez. And let's have a little look. If we press 4, that's a little map thing. That's pretty cool. I'm kind of in love with this game already, must be said. Let's take a little look at what we've got. We've got a baked potato, just like the mission. Mars mission? What's that game called? Film. Book. The Martian, obviously. Steamed carrot. So we've got some food. We've got a few glass things with water. We've got medikit and bandages and structures. We've got habitats, airlocks, barracks, biodomes, hallways and laboratories. Oh my god. Utilities. Forge, depository, large solar panel, beacon. Oh, loads of... pretty cool stuff, and then some furniture for the inside of our buildings as well. So I'm assuming the habitat, the inflatable dome is like a temporary thing so we can go explore and survive, and then we use the habitat as like a ground base, I guess. So at the moment I've got a chisel for mining mineral ores and melee combat. This is used for repairing stuff. This is patch tape, obviously, and that is our map. So we're looking for an ammo box. I'm gonna get my chisel out. Wah-ha! I'm gonna follow my personal assistant. He's gonna leave me. If press M. Oh, look at the ammo box that was dropped somewhere near the crash site. Okay. Did I not already do that? It's not another thing I picked up. I don't really want to go near the big spooky thing over there. So we're going... Ah! Hello, you cheeky little blighter. Is my oxygen dropping? No. If I sprint, it drops. That's okay. So we've got a pistol, an assault rifle, and some magazines. Lovely jubbly. Let's get those equipped, shall we? I mean, I remember the correct buttons. Let's get the pistol out. Okay. If I get rid of that. Ah! There we go. Pachow! Just need to make sure it worked. Okie dokie, we are alive. Now, we're just gonna do the missions. You know, the game is gonna tell me how to survive, I guess. Minutes to save. Anyways, search for minerals to build forge. Okay, search the planet for the right minerals to start building a forge utility. The forge is an outdoor crafting temple that can use to build more complex materials that need to expand your base to be more useful. Okay, so navigate to utilities and forge. So we need 4 iron, 2 titanium, and 4 plutonium, and we also have to use our chisel to get them. I guess we just go hammer on some stuff. I'm gonna attack. Right, I'm gonna attack this. Good stuff. That worked. It is definitely the chisel I'm meant to be using, right? Yeah, cool. I'm a little nervous about that dude over there, I'm not gonna lie. It's very, Starship Troopers. Ah, no, oh god, there's a worm. Can I turn it up a little bit? It seems quiet. I thought it was okay, but it seems quiet. I want you guys to be able to hear the spookiness. It's a very desolate feeling to it. Nothing's trying to eat me yet. That looks like something I want to be mining, right? Over there. That looks pretty mineable. But there's something scooting around on the ground. A sandworm. Kind of shebang. Which I'd like to avoid if at all possible. There we go. Iron. Iron, aluminium. And then we're going to need to find some plutonium, right? What did I need? Oh, iron, titanium, and plutonium. Maybe over there? Ah, we'll look around. Let's get the iron we need first. Going to bosh you right in, son. Bosh, bosh, bosh! Yeah. Oh, there we go. I need a little work. Okay, I've got iron for frickin' days. I definitely needed 4, right? Is it going to show me that I've got... Yes, I've got 18. So we need to find some titanium. Oh no, spiky thing has killed me! Ah! So, I know, I get it. Are we okay? I think we're okay. I'm going to keep my pistol out. So we're going to shoot these little buggers. And that little bugger over there. What's that? Copper, iron. Where is my freaking plutonium and titanium? I'm just gonna keep exploring, but I am a little worried about that. Oh god. I've started a fight that I'm not really equipped for! Look at this thing! Yeah, kid! Raid dead creature. Bloop! I got alien meat, the most delicious of the meats. Dead larvae skeleopod. Look at that thing! It's like a facehugger, but big! Aluminium! No, I don't need aluminium! Can I fly? Oh, I can fly. Temporarily. I don't need the multi-tool on me, right? Let's get the map out. Is this going to tell me anything useful? No. I mean, I guess we just explore. I don't really know what else to do. Hearing my own breathing is kind of freaking me out a little bit, though. What is that? It's like a terror bird. But in space. Hello? Are you like a bird? I'm like a bird. Gonna fly away. What are you? Are we friends? Can we be friends? Or check. Level one. It's only level one. We're gonna be okay. Hello? I'm gonna shoot you now, okay? Stupid orc egg. What's it doing? That's what alien meat. Obviously. No, my meat! My meat! My meat is gone. Sure do breathe a lot, don't I? Shut up, me! I can't find these minerals. I don't have a freaking clue. There's something shiny over there, though. Very shiny. A little too shiny, if you ask me. It says charges. Oh, okay. That's not what it means. Plutonium. Titanium. That's what we're looking for here. I'm very suspicious of that. I kind of want to just like... Alright, Liddy. You guys know Liddy. Come here, Liddy. Take her hat off. Liddy. She sits, right? Like, there. On my speakers, right? Wait a minute, I can make this work. She sits on my speakers. But at night time, you look to the right, and like, where she's positioned, she's just like staring straight at me, and it's actually vaguely terrifying, I'm not gonna lie. What is that? This looks promising, this whole area. Titanium, there we go, boys! And girls. Got my chisel out. A bit of a trek back from home, though. Oh well. Yeah! Pachow! Pachow! Alright, that'll do. Okay. So, we found, like... I need to build beacons. It'd be good to be able to note this place as like a titanium pit. You know, so we'd always know to come back here if down the line I need more titanium. It'd be good to know that this is like a thing. But, I don't have any beacons. So we can't do that, can we? We can't at all. All we're looking for is the dabble of plutonium. A little dabble of plutonium and we are Dunzel Washington. I'll tell you that for free, lads and lasses. Well, there is definitely shiny things over there, but the plutonium on this thing is very, very green. So, yeah. I'm looking for something exceptionally green. Not creepy sand skater thing over there. Also don't know where the hell I am. But hey, it's the first episode. If we're going to do anything in the first episode, we're going to randomly explore, like, what basically looks like Mars, if we're honest. And then in the future, if people want to see more, we can go build some bigger stuff and habitats and... I really want to build, like, an eco... The hell is... I'm going to go look at that thing, because it's large. Stop breathing. Well, don't stop breathing. That would be silly, but... You know, calm down, lad. You've been sprinting for about 2 seconds. That came out of the ground. I'm pretty sure it's going to kill me if I get too close to it. Yet I... Liddy, stop. Yet I appear to be walking directly towards it. There's my biome on the left. Right, that's good to know. At least I know where I am. That looks plutonium-y to me. I think I'm looking like maybe for a cave? System? What are you doing, son? Hello? Pachow! Yeah, I thought that'd get your attention. Colossus, level one. This may have been a mistake! Okay, it's fine. It seems to be struggling with that low ma- Oh! Urgh. Light weapon proficiency. Yeah, I am. I think you bugged out a little. Get it? Bugged out? That's good stuff. Ha ha! Sorry. I wasn't really doing anything wrong. I should have. I feel mean about killing him now. I don't feel mean. Right, there's my biovac kind of thing over there. Let's go this way. Hydration is okay. Health and suit is full. Pressure is good. Temperature is good, maybe. I don't really know. See, my spawn position is this way. What's that arrow in the top left? What's the point in the arrow? It's pointing this way, right? Arrow wants me to go this way. And it's right next to the words spawn position. This clearly is not the direction of my spawn position. Which is back there somewhere. And then I point that way and the arrow doesn't want me to go over there. It's very confusing. Maybe it's going to take me to some plutonium. Maybe. Shut up! I don't want to sprint just because he's like. This looks promising. This looks cavey. If this is like a ditch, or is it just shadow? It's just shadow, isn't it? Shut up, Besson Slot. What's that? Is that copper? Oh. Nah! Yo! Gotta get my sprint on. Where's this freaking plutonium? It's all I want to achieve today. Plutonium. I'm not asking for much. I'm a simple man with simple pleasures. All I need is some plutonium. Don't we all just need some plutonium, really? Is there any way to track that? I still don't have legs. Mildly disappointing. I have a strong suspicion I'm not meant to be going this far to search for plutonium. Nah, it's meant to be close. Ah! No, something green there. There, right there. It's green. Chow! Now, it could try to kill me. It could just be a plant. Or it could be plutonium. It's also next to what appears to be a very large ball. I think that's meant to be a planet. We're heading this way. It's green. It's the first green thing I've seen. I think it's green. I don't know if you guys can even see it. I can barely see it. Also appears to disappear as I get closer to it. I have a horrible suspicion I didn't actually see a green thing. But it's... We're going this way anyway, okay? I'm pretty sure that thing in the top left is actually a compass, Besson Slot. So I'm heading north right now, I guess. There's nothing here. What did I see? I see it there again. Oh, it is. It's like smoke or gas or something. That could be plutonium. Maybe. Thought there was something behind me then. It's a freaking car outside. Don't drive when I'm recording videos, please. This is the most promising thing I've seen. This gas chamber. Okay, it's also next to a bloody... A whatchamacallit. And who's it? Ow! Tumbo! He's very slowly approaching. He's got a lot of health! I mean, it's got a lot of health, and it's large, but it's not the most threatening thing in the world. I'm not gonna lie. Stupid Tumbo. Why is that in the middle of your face? Like a little, I'm sorry for shooting you, buddy. We can be friends if you just back away. ...360 no scope. Yes, plutonium. Yes, finally. Oh, sweet Jesus! Never been so happy to see something so green and ready. What's the word? Alright, I'm gonna collect quite a lot of this. I don't know. Backpack at 136 capacity, does that mean I can't sprint or? Okay, I'm gonna drop some stuff. What should I drop? A bit of titanium. A little bit. Split. Drop. Am I okay now? It's hard to tell. No. 100 faith. Oh, God. Oh, fine. There we go. No longer done. Whee! Yeah, there is a big difference. And I'm going to sprint all the way home. Oh, Libby! You like hook her onto me. That's hard to swear. Because it's freaking boiling. I mean, it looks like a bit of a hot planet, doesn't it? I think I'm going to go stand in the shade. Well, that cools me down. Also, what's going on here? Why is there like a random sandstorm buffeting my facial regions? I'm always up for a bit of buffeting, but this is silly. Also, I'm going the wrong way. No, I'm not. I need to head south, don't I? I'm not loving the sweat. Can we stop it, please? I can't see a freaking thing right now. Okay, okay, buddy. What is going on? It's dirty and musty and sweaty and... It's basically like my love life. Just need to get back. We're going to build ourselves a forge. We're going to save the game. We're going to be happy with our first episode endeavor. I'm very proud of us so far. On you. Yeah. I need bigger shoulders. More smaller shoulders. It's kind of creepy. I wonder if it ever turns to nighttime. It could be pretty creepy at night. I do have a flashlight. Somewhere. I don't really know where. F doesn't activate it, so maybe I don't have one yet. But I have a flashlight battery. Let's put it that way. I think that noise is meant to be, like pebbles from this dust storm hitting my, mask. It's kind of weird. It's definitely getting a little spookier. I thought I was sweating. Now I would explain the prolific amounts of water coming down the screen. But it appears to be raining, actually. It's a whole different looking place than it was a minute ago. It's a lot cooler. Oh, God. Alright, I don't want to fight you, buddy. You stick to your end, I'm going to stick to mine. I know the biovac is down there. I feel like Matt Damon. Mark Wahlberg? Matt Damon. That would also explain the noise, which I assumed was dust, but I'm pretty sure it's rain. Also, it's going to make this very difficult to see my home. Is it on the thing? I'm going to have to note down my longitude, latitude coordinates when I can. But I think if I just run straight forward, we'll find it. Maybe? Alright, alright. I want to wipe the screen, you know? It's actually really annoying that I can't do it. This looks promising. It's going to be hard to spot. I can barely see through all the mist and... It sounds dumb. But, well, give me a minute. From my perspective, it's like, the music was good, I don't have a problem with the music. My problem is more that... It's a survival game, right? The idea is that I am this person trapped on this planet. I'm just trying to survive and... hopefully find my way back home through the mist and the dust and the monsters and everything. Why would there be music? There's no reason for there to be music. Music was nice, but in games like this, I think it's not great for immersion, so we're gonna knock it off for now. We might put it back on later, depends how I'm feeling, but right now I kind of want to... Alright, loads of iron, loads of iron. I think just over this little ridge here is home. I think. I have to make some beacons. Lickety split. Is that it? Is that it there? You're very bright, son. Is that it? Yes, it is! It is! I can see my little friend! Oh, it's Jennifer Lopez. This place became much creepier since I was last here, it must be said. Jeez Louise. Hello, beautiful. Bedtime, okay? Oh, is it 4 minutes until I can save again, maybe? Yes, right. Okay. We're gonna end it there then, because 5 minutes till I can save and I actually have to go. It's World of Warcraft night, so I have to go be a nerd. Thank you very much for joining me though. I'd love to play a little bit more of this. Let me know in the comments. I think it's got a bit enough of a spooky vibe that we could realistically carry this on into Halloween month anyway, but we have lots of stuff planned for Halloween month coming up. But I'm excited. It's just nice to play a good old-fashioned, pretty cool survival game again, you know? So, yeah, let me know in the comments if you're going to see it anymore, and I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers, much love, and as always, bye-bye.